Okay friends, have a good day. Today we are going to discuss some concepts related to the timeline distance effects. If we want to solve the questions related to the time and the distance, time, speed and the distance, we have to be aware of some basic things. If I start from the basic things, you are all aware of one basic formula, that is speed is equal to total distance divided by time frames. Okay, I can write S is equal to d by t. This is the basic formula. This is the first point. Second point, I have to be aware of the units. Friends, distance here, we are calculating the distance in the form of centimeters, in the form of meters, in the form of kilometers, friends. Usually. Okay. And the time, we are calculating it in the form of seconds, or in the form of minutes, or in the form of hours. Now you see how I have to be convert from centimeter to meter, meter to kilometer. If you see 100 centimeters is equal to 1 meter. 100 centimeters is equal to 1 meter. If I want to convert centimeter to meter, you see, here is the 100, here is the 1. If I want to avoid these two zero, it's quite naturally I have to be divide this by 100, then only I will get to 1. So you see, if you want to convert anything else from centimeter to meter, we have to be divided by 100. Similarly, from meter to kilometer, we have all known it, 1000 meters is equal to 1 kilometer. If I want to convert from a meter to kilometer, I have to be divide that by 1000, because if I want to be erase these three zeros, because here I have only one, I have to be divide this by 1000. So this is the second step, that is divided by 1000. Okay. Similarly, if you want to convert kilometer to meters, you have to be multiply by 1000. And if you want to convert meter to centimeter, you have to be multiply that by 100. Very simple. Similarly, friends, if I want to be converts second to minutes, we are all known it in our life, 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute. 1 minute. Right? If I want to avoid this 60, I have to be divide it, because I want to get to 1 here. Right? If you divide this by 60, you will get to 1. Right? If you want to convert second to minute, I have to be divide it by 60. Similarly, 60 minutes make 1 hour. Hence, if you want to convert a minute to hour, once again I have to be divided by 60. Similarly, if I want to convert hour to minute, I have to be multiplied by 60, and a minute to second also I have to be multiplied by 60. First step you have to be remember. And as well as the distance is concerned, you may get it in the form of centimeters, or in the form of meter, or in the form of kilometer. Whereas in the time is available in the form of seconds, or in the form of minute, or in the form of hour, friends. Okay. So usually speed is available
in the form of meter per second. Meter distance is available in the form of meter, and time is available in the form of seconds. Or usually, or the same speed is also available. The data is available in the form of kilometer, distance is available in the form of kilometer, and time is available in the form of hour. I am usually talking it is a kilometer per hour and it is a meter per seconds, friends. Meter per seconds. Okay. So here, first point, whatever the data you have, which is available in the form of kilometer per hour, if you want to convert it in the form of meter per second, what to do? Just to see that. Okay. So here I'll write 1 kilometer in 1 hour. In 1 hour, if I convert 1 kilometer to meters, then quite naturally 1 kilometer is equal to 1,000 meters divided by 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Once again, minute can be converted in the form of seconds multiplying by 60 times. It means, so I can write 1 kilometer is nothing but 1000 meters, 1 hour is nothing but 60 into 60 seconds. So after simplification, what happens? This 0, you can cancel. 2 5s are 10, 2 3s are 6. Ultimately, I will get here 5. It is meters. And divided by 18, it is seconds. Okay. So, 1 kilometer per hour is equivalent of 5 by 18. Means 5 meter per seconds. 5 meter per seconds. Since, if you want to convert the given data, which is available in kilometer per hour, to meter per second. Here, meter per seconds. Quite naturally, what else I have to be do? I have to be multiply the given data by 5 by 18. Where from it comes 5 by 18? Here from, friends. Okay. You see, first point, if the given data is in the form of kilometer per hour, to convert it in the form of meter per second, I have to be multiply the given data in 5 by 18. Similarly, if meter per second, if I want to convert it in the form of kilometer per hour, okay, what to do? I have to be multiply this by 18 by 5. Reverse, friends. 18 by 5. These are the two points just to remember, because usually I do get the formula speed is equal to distance divided by time. Okay. And if I want to be convert it in other form, time is equal to distance divided by speed, whereas distance is equal to speed into time. Speed into time, all are same questions. The speed is equal to distance divided by time, whereas time is equal to distance by speed, and distance is equal to speed into time. This is the basic formula, and these are the conversions, friends. And meanwhile, if I have the data, it in the form of centimeter, how I have to be convert in the form of meters, we have seen. Okay, if I have the data in the form of meters, if answer keys are available in the form of centimeters, then quite naturally how I have to be convert, here I have given. You see, okay, how we have to be converted to second to minute, minute to hours. If I want to convert second to minute, I have to be divided by 60. Minute to hours, once again, I have to be divided by 50, 60. Whereas, if I want to convert hour to minute, I have to be multiplied that by 60 and minute to seconds, I have to be multiply again a minute by 60, I will get the seconds. Okay, this is the first step. This is the first step. You have to remember how we have to be convert the given data. Next friends. If in my question, two objects are available, it may be two buses, two cars, two trains, etc. Or otherwise, one is the train, another is the man, a bicycle drive, okay, or otherwise a motorcycle is moving. Likewise, anyway, if you have the two objects, then what to do, friends? Quite naturally, if you have the two objects, you will get the two speeds. And if I am talking about the trains, length of the train, I have to be considered. Okay, wherever you do get the length, that is nothing but the distance. Okay, you see what happens, friends. You see, this is my point. Here is my point. A as well as B. A as well as B. Both are here. Now both are moving in the same direction. What happens? Speed of the A is 2 km per hour. Speed of the B is 3 km per hour, friends. Okay. Both are started simultaneously from the same point. After 1 hour, A is here. And after 1 hour, B is here, friends. It means after 1 hour, the distance between the A and B is this much. Okay. B had covered here 3 kilometers, whereas A has covered here 2 kilometers. Okay. So in here, A you are getting, and here you are getting the B. After 1 hour, distance between the A and B is just 1 kilometer. How it could be 1 kilometer? Okay, simple. After 1 hour, he has covered 3 kilometers, and after 1 hour, A has covered 2 kilometers. So it means, okay, after 1 hour, difference between A and B, or distance between A and B, is created here 1 kilometer. How do you do get that 1? We are all know, here we are getting that 1. From 3 minus 2, friends. So one point you have to be take down here, if two objects are moving in the same direction, two objects are moving in the same direction, I'll write like this. Both are moving in the same direction, A as well as B. Okay, if two objects are moving in the same direction, to get the actual speed or distance between them, to get the actual speed, we have to take the difference between both the speeds. Okay. To get the actual speed, we have to take difference between both the speeds. Difference between both the speeds, friends. Both the speeds. Okay. Example here we have seen, if A's speed is 2 km per hour and B's speed is 3 km per hour, if both are started from the same point simultaneously, after 1 hour, B has covered 3 km and A has covered just 2 km and the difference between those two objects would be 1 km. I can say the distance between them after 1 hour is 1 km. Okay, this is the another point that you have to remember. Okay, another point. If both the objects, this A and B, has started from the same point simultaneously in the opposite direction. A is moving towards this direction and B is moving towards this direction. If both are moving in the opposite direction, after 1 hour, B has covered 3 kilometers this side and A has covered 2 kilometers from that side. Okay, then after 1 hour, quite naturally, the distance between those two guys is this much. How much it is? 3 plus 2. It is nothing but 5. It is nothing but 5 friends. Okay, you see, if both the objects are moving in the opposite direction to get the actual speed, what I have to be do? I have to be at both the speeds. It may be 3 km per hour. I can say it is per hour. It is 2 km per hour. Okay. Then quite naturally after 1 hour they are 5 km apart each other. So another point you have to be remember, friends. And right, if two objects are, if two objects are moving in the opposite direction, opposite means I'll write down here this type of the symbol. Here this is the symbol. Here is the A, here is the B. Just you remember. If two objects are moving in the opposite direction, to get the actual speed, we have to take sum of both the speeds. Sum of both the speeds. This is the another point you have to remember. Here, what is that point? If two objects are there in the question, if both are moving in the same direction, to get the actual speed, I have to take a difference between both the speeds. If two objects are moving in the opposite direction like this, to get the actual speed, we have to take sum of both the speeds. Okay, meanwhile, another point. If I have the trains, quite naturally length of the train is being considered as a distance. Okay. So you see here, now you consider this is the platform. This is the platform that is 200 meters length. A train is moving, 20 kilometers per hour. Which is having a 100 meter length. Please to listen, friends. Here this is the platform. Okay, 200 meter long. And this is the train. It is 100 meter long and moving 20 kilometer per hour. Okay. So, you see here, when the train is reaches the platform. Okay. Then, engine is somewhere here, friends. Okay, please to remember, when a train is reached the platform, train's engine is somewhere here. If the last bogie of the train has crossed the platform, there somewhere here is the engine of the train. Right? If I am using the word, a train crosses the platform. Train crosses the platform. Okay. When should I have to be said train crosses the platform? Okay. This point the train is reached and this point the train is crossed flights. Okay. Reach and cross. In between these two points, this much of the distance, the train has to be covered here. The train has to be covered, friends. One, the distance of the platform, 200 meter. Another length of the train, friends. It means a train has crossed the platform. Okay. If I use this word to cross that platform, train has to be run not only 200 meters, it has to be travel 100 more meters, which is its length. Okay, here you have the speed, here we have the speed. Okay, they may give some time. Okay, and here as far as the distance is concerned, what else I have to be do? Okay, I have to be at 200 plus 100. Okay, so that a train has to be crossed 300 meters, friends. Then only I can able to say train has crossed the platform. Okay, so it means how much distance the train is covering here? 300 meters. Where from 300 meter it comes? It comes 200 plus 100. Means I am adding, friends. Okay. Another question. If both are the trains, what happens? Okay, let it see. This is the one train. 100 meters length. And just to see, this is moving 20 kilometer per hour. 20 kilometer per hour. Another train, imagine this is the train which is coming from other side, 120 meters long, and it is a 30 kilometer per hour. It's a speed, friends. It's a speed. Okay. Now you see, I am talking here, train A is 100 meter long, moving 20 kilometer per hour speed. In the opposite direction, another train is coming, having 120 meters long with a speed of 30 kilometer per hour. I may ask a question, in how much time they do cross with each other? If my question is related to the time, friends, you see, if I want to calculate the time, I require the distance as well as the speed, right? Okay, since both the objects are moving from the opposite direction, I have to be added these two speeds. Quite naturally, I will get speed is equal to S1 plus S2. You see, this is the S1, this is the S2, no problem. Okay, then I have to say it is the 50 km per hour. S is over. Then to get the time, I required to calculate the D. For D, what happens? You see, what else I have to do for D? Okay, see, friends, what happens here? See, if both the trains are here, okay, I'll use the word met with each other. See, I can say, if both the engines are here, I use the word, both the trains are met with each other. I'm not supposed to be say it is crosses. It crosses. Okay, just it met with each other. Okay. When should I have to be say cross with each other? Friends, you see, if this train has traveled that side, or this train has started this side, whatever it may be. Okay, if last bogie of this first train, this is the first train, is, and this is the second train, last bogie of the first train and last bogie of the second train has coming over here, okay, then only I can say both the trains are crossed with each other. Crossed with each other. Friends, did you observe? When first train engine is here, I have used, they have met with each other. And when that the same train engine is here, I have said that is crossed. Okay. Here I have said meet, here I have said crossed. Okay, from meet to cross, the trains has to be covered this much of the distance, friends. How much distance we are expecting here? Quite naturally, the length of this train and the length of this train. Okay, so if I want to use a cross, once again I have to be add both the distances. Here also I have to be add both the distances. Here also I have to be at both the distances. It may be 120 meters or it may be 100 meters. I have to be at 120 plus 100. Okay. In the second case also we have seen cross. Whenever I am using the word cross, okay, I require to add the distances. Both the distances. D1 as well as the D2. If I say this is the D1 and this is the D2, I have to be added D1 plus D2. Okay. Another phrase. You see. If both the trains are moving in the same direction. For example, first train. Okay. T1 is having 100 meter length. Moving 30 kilometer per hour. Another train is moving in the same direction, which is 120 kilometer. Okay, sorry, 120 meters. It is a train 2 moving 20 kilometer per hour. 20 kilometer per hour. Okay, if it is the situation, then friends, in this case, 100% this train will cross this train. Right? First train will definitely cross the second train. Okay, here if I ask, it what time or how much time the train will take to cross with each other, if it is my question. In my question, I have the length of first train, length of second train. Speed of first train, speed of second train. Okay, my formula related to the time is D divided by S, distance divided by speed. Speed anyhow I can convert, because since both the objects are moving in the same direction, I will take difference between both the speeds here. Difference between both the speeds. I can say 10 km. 10 km per hour. After we will solve some questions. That I will get. Yes, I will get. As far as the D is concerned, what happens you see, friends? D is concerned, what happens you see? Please you see. Okay, friends, if you see, when this train is, okay, reaches here, I will use the word reach. The first train, if it reaches the last bogie, I can say the faster train will reach the slow train. And when I am talking about crosses, the faster train has crossed, the last bogie of the faster train has crossed. It means when the train once engine is here, I am using the word reaches. Meanwhile, when the same engine is somewhere here, I can say the word cross. From reach to cross, the fastest train has to be covered this much of the distance. How much, friend, it is? It is one, the distance of T2, and this is the distance of T1. Okay, now it is the T2 plus T1, the length of T2 as well as length of T1, right? From reach to cross, friends. from reach to cross, what else I am doing here? I am adding both the distances. So in this case, this is a platform. In this case, both are the trains traveling in the opposite direction. In this case, both are the trains traveling in the same directions. Okay. So in all cases, what we have seen, in all cases we have observed, I have to add both the distances, friends. Okay. After this, you have to be come to a conclusion. What is that conclusion? Okay. What is that conclusion? All right, over here. To get the total distance. To get the total distance, irrespective of the state, whether it is the static or dynamic. Here platform is a static, trains are dynamic, both are moving, it is a standing. Since I am using the word irrespective of the state and a direction. Why I have to use this word? Direction means whether both the trains are moving in the opposite direction or moving in the same direction. Okay, it means irrespective of the state and direction, we have to add both the distances. So both the length, friends. So this point you have to be remember here. This point you have to be remember, friends. Okay, these are all the basic points you have to be remember. You have to be remember first one basic formula, that is speed is equal to total distance divided by time. If you want to solve the questions related to the time, the same formula you can write, distance divided by speed. Whereas if you want to calculate the distance, the same you can say speed into time. It is a one basic formula. 90% of the questions we will try to solve by using the basic formula. Of course, in each and every step you will get the different formulas which is articulated, you may get it in the book, but it is very difficult us to remember, and the same thing has to be recalled in the examination in time. It is difficult. Try, no problem. If you want, you can. But if I do not remember and recall the same thing in the exam, then how can I answer? Since I would like to be solo, almost all 90% of the questions from the basic theme. Okay, we will try. While we are solving the questions, we have to remember some points. Okay, that is the one point, is the conversion. Unit is very important. Basic questions we are getting from the units that we have seen, friends. What is that? Okay, distance may be available in the form of centimeter. It may be in the form of meters, or it may be in the form of kilometer. Time, that may be available in the form of seconds, or in the form of minute, or in the form of hours. Okay, but in a majority of the cases, speed is available either in the form of meter per hour. It means distance is in the form of meter, speed, okay, time is in the form of second. It is meter per second or kilometer per hour. If I required it to be converted, then I have to be remember to convert the given data which is available in kilometer per hour to meter per second. I have to be multiply the given data by
5 by 18 that we have already seen. Another point, if I want to convert it in a reverse order, it means from meter per second to kilometer per hour, I have to be multiply the given data by 18 by 5. Second point. Third, in the question, if I have two objects, definitely I have to be faced two speeds and different directions. Okay, then. What else I have to remember there? If two objects are moving in the same direction, to get the actual speed, we have to take a difference between both the speeds. Another point, if two objects are moving in the opposite direction, to get the actual speed, we have to take sum of both the speeds. And another point, whenever we are solving the question, I have to be consider the D also. Okay. So it means irrespective of, to get the total distance, irrespective of the state and direction. It may be the same direction or it may be the opposite direction. It may be the platform, it may be the bridge, or it may be the line of the trees, something else. Okay, it may be the static body. It may be the static body, or it may be the moving bodies. Moving bodies, it means a state. These two are the trains here. One is the train, another is the platform. Since I have used the word, to get the total distance, irrespective of the state and the direction, we have to be at both the distances to get the total distance. Okay, so this is the another point you have to remember. Okay, next, another relations we will create. Friends, if I see this formula, D is equal to S into T, friends. S into T. Okay. Now, I'll take one example, friends. Okay, write it in a reverse direction just to see. This is the S, this is the T, this is the T. S into T is equal to D, friends. If I say my car is running 20 km per hour. If it runs 4 hours, what happens, have you seen? This hour you can cancel. Then I have to be saying it is the 40 km I'll run. If my car is running 20 km per hour, in 4 hours, I'll cover 40 km, friends. Okay, very clear. Very clear. Here you see, if I keep distance is constant, if I want to cover only 40 km, next time, if my, instead of car, if I have taken bicycle and my bicycle speed is 10 km per hour, then quite naturally, okay, here 80 km, friends, only 4 2s are 8. Okay, you see here, 4 2s are 80 km. If my bicycle speed is 10 km per hour, then how many hours I required here? 8 hours I required. Then only I can cover the same distance. Friends. Here you have observed one point. If distance is a constant, here what happens? Speed has decreases. Then automatically time has increases, friends. In another case, if my speed is, instead of 40 km per hour, quite naturally within 2 hours, I'll complete this much of the distance.
It means if I increase the speed, quite naturally, time is automatically decreases. Okay? Alright, friends. From this point, you have to be remember, if a distance is a constant, in the given question, if the distance is constant, then the speed and the time, how they are related? They are related inversely proportional to each other. Speed and time is inversely proportional to each other. It means, my friend, if I say S becomes S1, S becomes S1, 2S2, earlier it was S1, now it is S2, then quite naturally, time is 1 divided by T1 to T2, because if distance is constant, speed and time is inversely proportional to each other. S is equal to 1 by T. Friends. Okay. Now here you see what happens. S1 divided by S2 is equal to, if I write in a reverse direction, it becomes T2 divided by T1, friends. Then if I once again simplify, you will get S1 into T1 is equal to S2 into T2. Friends, you have to be remember, if distance is a constant, I'll write here, if distance is a constant, then what type of the relation I do get here? S1 into T1 is equal to S2 into T2, friends. This is the one relation you will get. Okay? If a distance is constant, okay, remaining S and T is available in this relation. Another case, friends, here you see. You take that if distance is a constant. You see here, my car is running 20 km per hour. If I take 4 hours, quite naturally I will cover 80 km. That is known. Here I want to be keep 4 hours as it is every time. Friends. You see, this is a constant. It means I am keeping the time is a constant. Okay. Next time, what I'll do, I'll increase the speed from 20 to 30, friends. 30 km per hour. Quite naturally, how much distance I would able to cover in this here? 3, 4 is 12. 120 km, right? What happens? Did you observe if the time is constant, then if you increase your speed, quite naturally distance is also increases. If you decrease the speed from 20 to 10, it is a 10 km per hour. Here I have decreased the speed, then quite naturally I have covered lesser distance when I compare to this. Okay, friends, in this case you have observed, if I have kept time is a constant, here are three factors. One, we have seen distance. Another, I will show you, if a time is a constant, another factor we have observed, if speed is increases, automatically distance is increases. If a time speed is a decreases, automatically distance is a decreases. Alright? Okay, friends. So, here I can say, if a t is a constant, then remaining speed as well as the distance is directly proportional to each other. How it is? If you make S1, it is a D1. If it is S2, automatically it is a D2. It means S1 divided by S2 is equal to D1 divided by D2. If S1 becomes S2, then automatically D1 becomes a D2. D1 becomes a D2. If you simplify, you see S1 into D2. S1 into D2 is equal to S2 into D1. S2 into D1 finds. Okay. Another relation you have seen here. If time is a constant. If time is a constant. Constant. The relation you will get here. S1. S1. D2 is equal to S2 D1. S2 D1. It means speed as well as the distance, both are directly proportional to each other. Directly proportional to each other friends. Okay. Next. Means while I am solving the question, I have to be see that in the given question, which factor is a constant. If I do come across any one factor is here constant, then I can use these relations. Okay, we'll see in the next we'll see in the coming classes how we are using these formulas while we are solving the question, but let me see the basics first. Okay, another factor you have here. What I'll do in another factor finds, you see here. Okay, if I keep speed is a constant. Okay. 20 km per hour I'll keep constant. 20 km per hour I'll keep constant. Constant. Okay. Now just to check out here. Okay. If I increase the time, instead of 4 hours, if I take 5 hours, it means I have increased here the time. Quite naturally, distance is automatically increases. Distance is automatically increases. Right? Okay. Another one. If I decrease the time, instead of 4 hours, if I take 3 hours, I have decreased it. Quite naturally, your distance is just 60 kilometers. When I compare to 80, it decreases. Okay? In another case, you have seen friends, if the speed is constant, S is constant. If the speed is constant, okay, then what happens here? If time increases, simultaneously, distance is also increases. If time decreases, distance will also decrease. I can say, if speed is a constant, then remaining time and distance are directly proportional to each other. How can you write? If T1 became a T2, automatically D1 became a D2. Then after simplification, you can write T1 into D2 is equal to T2 into D1. T2 into D1. Is that right? Okay. I can write here, if S is the constant, speed is a constant, here is the speed is the constant, then quite naturally T1 into D2 is equal to T2 into D1. This is the relation friends. This is the relation you will get. Okay. After observing these three points, what you have observed here, S1 and T1 is always together. S2, T2 is always together. And along with S1, here you are getting the D2. And along with the T1, here you are getting the D2. Along with S2, here you are getting D1. And along with the T2 also, you are getting the D1. If I club all put together, ultimately I can arrange one more relation. S1, T1, it is a D2, is equal to S2, T2, D1, friends. This is the relation we may get, friends. These are the basic things. Okay. First, if I want to solve some basic questions,
I should have to be have these are the basic
okay
knowledge. Then only I can very easily solve some of the questions, friends. This is the simple basic thing you should remember. You should remember, friends. Okay? Okay, friends. Now, how, at what type of the questions you do get? What type of the questions you do get, friends? Okay. Let me see some questions. Okay, one or two questions. Okay, fine.
See, next class onwards, just you keep the booklet with you and the notebook also. You will come to know that the different variety of the questions. Okay, here one question I'll discuss. Friends, if I do read, a bus covers 572 kilometers in 13 hours. A bus covers a distance is 572 kilometers in 13 hours. T is equal to 13 hours. Still listen. A bus covers 572 kilometers in 13 hours. What is the speed of the bus? What is the speed of the bus? That to be in meters per second. I have shown you here meters per second. It is because some of the time they may ask. Okay. Or otherwise, the options may be available in meter per second. Here quite naturally you have the distance, you have the time. What is the formula for S? S is equal to total distance divided by time. D is here 572 kilometers. Here T is equal to 13 hours, friends. After simplification, I may get kilometer per hour. Unit I may get here kilometer per hour, friends. Kilometer per hour. Okay. So if you want, you can see that 13 ones are 13, 13 fours are 52. 13 fours are 52. Again, 13 fours are 52. Your answer should be 44 kilometers per hour. If I want it in the form of meter per second, so simple, I have to be multiply this 44 into 5 by 18. That is nothing but meter per seconds. You can simplify. 2 9s are 2 2s are. It means okay, 22 5s are 110. It is meters. It covers in 9 seconds, friends. 9 seconds. Okay. This could be my answer. 110 meters per 9 second is the speed of that bus or that car, whatever it may be. Or if you would have asked directly, very simple question it is. Very simple question. We can answer. Friends. Okay. Now, if I take another question, another basic question, friends. Here, I'll read one more question. A 275 meter long train. Here, A 275 meters long train. Friends, whenever I do come across this word, I'll complete the question. But before completing the question, while I am reading, I'll get the data. 275 meters long. If I do use this, quite naturally, what is it? It is nothing but the D. 275 meters. I will take it. A 275 meters long train.
crosses a platform having equal in its length. Crosses a platform of equal length. Equal length. It means after D1 length of the train, D2 it is also 275 meters platform. Okay, platform is the train, length of the train, this is the length of the platform. Platform in 33 seconds. Here he has given in 33 seconds. What is this 33 seconds? Quite naturally it is time. 33 seconds, it is the time. Alright, my question is here, what is the speed of the train in kilometer per hour? What is the speed of the train in kilometer per hour? This is the question mark. I require it in the form of kilometer per hour. You have their options. You have their options in kilometer per hour, friends. Kilometer per hour. Okay. You see how we have to solve this question. We have the options there. We will see in the coming classes. This is the basic class. Okay. How we have to pick, what we have to do, we will see. Friends, my question is related to the S, and I know the basic formula, speed is equal to distance divided by time. S is equal to distance divided by time, and here D1 I have D2, here I have D1 and D2. Just you remember, friends, if you have D1 and D2 both, what is the point you have gone through, irrespective of the state and the direction, to get the actual distance, always I have to be add. It means I require to add both. Actual distance I have to be add. That is nothing but D is equal to 550 meters. Is it right? 550 meters, one thing. Alright, S is equal to 550 meters, friends. Okay, next. Here, T is equal to 33 seconds. 33 seconds, friends. Okay. But my answer should be in the kilometer per hour. Then what to do? To convert the given data which is available in meter per second to kilometer per hour, I have to be multiply this by 18 by 5, friends. 18 by 5. Then this data is going to be get converted in kilometer per hour. Then we will simplify what happens. 5 ones are 5. 5 ones are 5. 5 ones are 5. Then 11 ones are 11. 11 threes are 33. 3 ones are 3. 3 sixes are 18. So ultimately I will get 10 into 6. It is 60. Unit is kilometer per hour. Kilometer per hour. Okay, right, friends. In the next class, some more questions will solve. But please do keep the booklet with you. Okay, where I will give you the question number and page number. Okay. Now we'll concentrate some previous year question papers question. Just you keep with you. I'll read very slowly those questions, and I'll write the question number and the page number. Okay, page number, then we will solve. Okay, how many questions we can able to solve on similar concept. Okay, I'll highlight, and our basic questions I'll highlight, some questions I'll show you here, and remaining questions all you can solve. If you have any doubts, you may raise there. Okay, thank you, friends. We will see in the next class, but please do keep booklet with you, friends. Okay, thank you, friends. Thank you.